We're here in Seattle, an AL West matchup on the show. It's the Los Angeles Angels taking on the Seattle Mariners. First pitch coming your way next.
That's just waiting.
Just about ready to go, and towing the slab in this one, Luis Castillo. Chris, a sub-3 ERA for him a year ago.
Well, when your numbers are coming in under three as a starting pitcher that's going out there every fourth or fifth day, taking the ball, competing against really good big league hitters, it's extremely impressive. And you wonder what he figured out last year that he can carry into this season that can help him to maintain that number or even drop it lower. We'll see, but we know he's got good stuff and he should be really good in this one today.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
This to center field. Rodriguez settles under it. And out number one on the grab.
Batting third.
Here's Mike Trout. Big time power. In there, and it's 0-1. Luis Castillo, a guy who debuted in 2017 with the Reds at 24 years old, multiple All-Star appearances, traded to the Mariners at the deadline in 2022. You think about that triple dip. Haggerty settles under it and makes the catch. Two down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
Shohei Ohtani stands in now and watches strike one. Not close with that one, and the count is 1-1. Fletcher off of first with two away. Next pitch is outside. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Well, he looks to have some quality stuff on the hill today. Start this outing out, pepper in the zone, arm is loose, and firing him in there.
Check swing, tried to hold up. Now an appeal to third, no swing. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice plate appearance.
Now it's going to be Taylor Ward. Righty delivers. Ripped towards third, and it stays fair. Heading for the plate. He will score, and it's 1-0. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. They get a run. Back at T-Mobile Park, and the pitcher here today, Jose Suarez. What should we keep an eye on here?
Well, last year kind of around the league average in terms of ERA, and you know what?
And it gets by him.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock, and you'll take that in.
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. His first homer of the year, and they grab the lead. It's 2-1.
He went up there 0-0 looking to do damage. I think he had his sights set on that pitch. He went and got it and circled the bases.
Tommy La Stella to the plate. Next pitch is popped up and a foul ball.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Next offering way off the plate.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
And another ball. The pitch. Popped up. Walsh on the move. Makes the catch, and there's one gone. And now we check out the Mariners lineup. Already trailing by a run in this one. They'll be looking to get on the scoreboard early on as well.
Well, it's just the one run, so not too big a hill to climb. But, yeah, if they can answer back in this inning or at least in the next couple, that'll maybe settle everyone into this ball game, and that includes their own starter on the mound.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells.
Pollock runs. Pitch is low. Throw to second, and he's out.
Usually when you see a team try to steal a base in the early innings, it tells you they want to be aggressive on offense. Try to force the defense to make plays and slow them down. That's a.
Now a blast to left center, way back there, on its way, out of here. That'll fire up the dugout, his first homer of the year, and they add to the lead, it's 3-1.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for, crushes it, and hits it out of the ballpark.
Here's Dylan Moore. High in the air, out to right. Makes the catch, inning over. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now a 3-1 ball game. You're watching Mariners baseball on the show Northwest. New inning getting started. So in now for the Angels, Jared Walsh. Moore under it.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Next one off the plate inside, and it's 1-2. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Now all even up. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Swing and a miss. The high heat, too much on that one.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those. More margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport. And I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
And the righty deals. On the ground, right side. Sends it over to Listella. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Max Stassi comes up to hit. In there for strike one. And a strike.
He doesn't seem to like the pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
And that should be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. The throw in. Not in time. It's a double. Brett Phillips, the next to hit for the Angels. Sat out last night's game, but back in there today. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Late on that fastball.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Man at second. And that one hit 97 on the gun. Angels strand one, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. We head to the bottom of the second, and now it's going to be Eugenio Suarez. First offering in the dirt. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff for the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always.
Ripped into right field, base hit.
Batting it.
Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over it. Absolutely smoked that ball.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. Good power, not great in the OBP department. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Matthew Ross umpiring behind home plate for us in this one. He's got a reputation for having a bit of a wide strike zone, Chris.
Yeah, no doubt, Boog. He rewards pitchers when they're working the edges and sometimes a little bit beyond that. So for the hitters, just have to really be aware. Don't miss your pitch when you get it early in the count.
Swings and misses, struck him out.
Thought it was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Now it's Tom Murphy. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And that's outside. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Stassi pulls that one down, and there's two away.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Rodriguez stands in here, takes ball one low. The 1-0 swings through that one.
One strike.
Hammered down the right side, but foul. Suarez leads off first with two down to the inning. Next one just misses. 2-2.
It's a good take.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Got him. Inning over. One left for Seattle. And welcome back. Leading off, David Fletcher. The pitch. That one missed. Fletcher in his fifth season, 28 years old. And he was a sixth round draft pick back in 2015. Next offering is in for a strike. Just missed. The line of the pitch. He caught it behind his back. The throw got him. Great play to keep the leadoff man off base.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Castillo, a 6'2 righty, 200 pounds, and he was selected to the All-Star game last year. Urshela batting for the second time, and that's strike one. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time.
He's begging, give me that pitch one more time. A hanging changeup just out in front.
Lined, and that's a base hit.
Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way. And as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on. It's such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
Next one misses, and it's 2-0.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next one is off the play, and now 3-0. And a pitch. And a four-pitch walk.
Well, interesting. He went with the off-speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
And that one wrapped foul.
Always tough to turn two on a speedster like this. It's even harder with him coming out of the left-handed batter's box. You really need something to hit hard on the ground that they can handle to turn two quickly. He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next offering is down low.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
And he deals. Ouch. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, he didn't miss by much right there, but it was just enough to clip him on the way in.
Ward swings through it for strike one.
Everyone here understands just how quickly things could change.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner
Moore fires it to the plate. The tag, and they got him. And that'll do it.
Base runner decided to test him, and it was a bad decision. Outstanding throw on a frozen rope at home. That'll end the inning with a bang.
Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Lifted in the air, out to left. Ward drifts towards it. One down. Tommy La Stella up next for the Mariners. First pitch, not close. Suarez in his third season, 25 years old, and he was born in Venezuela. Swings and pulls it foul to the right side.
His eyes got big. He saw that changeup way out in front. Better to pull it than to get jammed on something off speed like that.
Bounced, and that got the pitcher. Sends it to Walsh. Out on a bang-bang play, but he made it close. Two outs, base is empty. A.J. Pollock at the dish. One for one. He singled to left his first time through. Swing and a foul straight back. Pollock, a former All-Star, a member of the 1,000 Hit Club. He joined the team as a free agent. Two outs. Off the mark there. And a count 1-2.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand, probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch. So got to stay ready for it.
And a ball and two strikes.
2-2.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Want to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Next offering is downstairs. Okay. throwing hard. Base hit. And that's going to roll to the wall. Around first, digging for two. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Wasting no time. He's 2 for 2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already.
Sam Haggerty up next for the Mariners. He's already homered here in this one. And the first offering is not close. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. That one's carrying, and forget it. That's what the fans came to see, and they add on. It's 5-1. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Rolled softly, but that goes foul. And a base hit up the middle.
That's now 3 hits in a row for the offense. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from.
And there he goes. Pitch misses in. Throw to second and great jump.
Well, I'm sure that steal will raise a couple of eyebrows because of this big lead, but I think it's more respect for their opponent, knowing that they've got to continue to add on if they're going to win this game. Don't take it as an offense. Take it as a sign of respect. Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Next offering is foul back. And now the lefty smashed to the left side and foul ball. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now 5-1. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back in Seattle, and here is Jared Walsh. The wide to kick the pitch. Foul ball.
You know, these Angels showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Rendon in the box now. No balls and a strike. Next pitch is popped up. Castillo settles underneath it, puts the squeeze on it, two away.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
Stassi stands in now and watches strike one. Fought off foul. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup.
I think the key is.
Welcome back. John Chavi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Teoscar Hernandez. That one ripped but foul. The 0-1. Swing and a pop up. Urshela drifts towards it and puts the squeeze on that. And there's one down. So here's Murphy now. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch.
And downstairs.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact, so not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind it.
Here's a 2-1. On the ground, out to short. A dive, he's got it. Throw to first, and he gets him. Nicely done.
Great cat-like reflexes right there. Lays out, knocks the ball down, and then fires with that rocket arm all the way across the diamond. Man, put this guy on the mound.
And that one lifted in the air center field. He's got it. And that is out number three. Mariners are down. Back at T-Mobile Park. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Brett Phillips. First pitch, and he just misses. And the slider catches the zone. And it goes just foul. Got him looking. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Here's David Fletcher. Singled and scored back in the first. He's one for two. And that's in there for strike one.
No ball. One strike.
Slapped foul. The next offering misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. One, two now. Ground ball up the middle. Crawford picks it up, whips it to first. And the first two set down on the top of the fifth. Two outs, bases empty. At the plate, Gio Urshela. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That's back. That one is gone.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Base is empty with two away. Here's some real power at the plate. Mike Trout. That one's in there, 0-1. At 30 years old, Mike Trout, 1,000 runs, 300 homers, 200 stolen bases. The only other players in Major League history with those numbers at that age, A-Rod and Willie Mays. Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball.
Well, they gave up on that pitch early, and it ended up staying in the zone. I'm sure he's kicking himself and would like that pitch again.
Next offering misses, and the count's even at two. Fights it off. He'll see another. 2-2 now. And down on strikes he goes. And that's the third out. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's 5-2. Back after this on the show. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford. And first offering is fouled off. The wind and the pitch. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Line drive. Makes the grab. One down. And here's the first baseman, Tommy La Stella. That one pulled foul. Next offering is down low. One ball, one strike. Left-hand batter waits. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. Chris, third time through the order, and a couple of quick outs for the starter.
Yeah, he's been very frugal today, economical with the pitch count.
Out to short. Fletcher collects it. Zips it to first, and they take care of Pollock for the out. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Here's Shohei Ohtani. First offering misses badly for ball one. And that's in for a strike. Singy, what do you prefer? You like watching Ohtani hit or pitch?
I think I like watching him hit. I mean, he hits monster home runs. And with guys on his team like Mike Trout and, you know, formerly Albert Pujols, to see Shohei Ohtani stand up and be a little bit taller than those other guys, it's just impressive.
Next one misses, 3-2 now. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
Matt Brash will take over here.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
Line and a base hit into right. Here's Ohtani flying around third. He's in with a double, and that's his second double of the night. In to score from first, and it's now a two-run game. So up next, Jared Walsh. In there, and it's 0-1. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Way inside, and that hit him.
Well, he's just glad that he got hit with an off-speed pitch there instead of a fastball. Man, that would have hurt a lot more if it had velocity.
Rendon goes after that one for strike one.
Big at bat right here with an opportunity to do damage. But on the flip side, ground ball, double play, strikeout. That could get the inning back under control on the mound.
On the ground to first, and it gets by him. Throw comes into third, and he's in safely at third. They pick up a run, and now it's a one-run game.
Not a bad slider by any means. It was down and away, but an even better job to spoil that thing. And he let it travel, didn't try to hook it. Man, that's a really good approach.
Lined, and that's a base hit. In comes the run from third. It's 5-5. Well, Singy, he is locked in there.
Well, he's really slowed the game down, and it's like he's moving in full speed and everybody is a step or two behind. The way that he squared up that baseball tells me that he is seeing it like a beach ball.
Paul Sewald into the game. This is his third time out this year. Now at the plate, Brett Phillips. And no one can get there. Coming home. One runs in. Stassi on his horse coming home. Crawford with a relay home. Not in time, he scores. It's 7-5. David Fletcher, the next to hit for the Angels. Hammered on a line to the left, base hit. Here's the throw to the plate. The tag, ow! Giorgella steps in. In there for strike one. Sewald, 32 years old. And he was a 10th round pick back in 2012. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. That's the second out. Here's Trout. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. Fletcher off of first with two away. That's pitch downstairs. And that's ball one. Well, Singy, Mike Trout, the resume speaks for itself. Ah, that ends the inning, so we take a break. And up next for Seattle, Sam Haggerty. He's got a couple homers already, so could he possibly do it again?
Come on, man. Of course he can. Those two he hit were legit, and he looks pretty locked in right now at the dip.
Liner caught it second. Dylan Moore getting ready to hit. One for two. And first offering is fouled off. Moore in his fifth season, 30 years old now. And usually he's a second baseman, but today he's starting in the outfield. Owen two now. Flying drive, and that's a base hit out into center field.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. Everything was on time.
New pitcher in the game for the Angels, Carlos Estevez.
And this is an important part of this game. Tight score and still a lot of outs to get, so they're looking.
Over to first, and he's safe. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. On a line, just inside the line, and it's down for a knock. And they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single. And now Teoscar Hernandez. Swings through that one, 0-1.
In this situation, the batter's got to know what the pitcher's trying to do to him, and that's trying to get him to hit the ball on the ground, get two for one. You got to look for something up in the zone. At worst case scenario, you deliver the sacrifice fly.
Movement in the bullpen, Ryan Tepera, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. And now 2-1 after that missed inside.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on, probably a challenge pitch coming.
Hard ground ball for a base knock. In to score from third. And now they trail by one.
Well, he gets it done in a big spot to get the run across. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way. And it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Two on, one out. Chases that one upstairs.
The high fastball, particularly for young hitters, can be hard to lay off of because you see it so well at eye level, but it's really hard to catch up and get that top hand to work on time.
Hammered on the line, base hit. And they stop him at third, so base is loaded with one away.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good.
Ah, that got him, and that's going to force in a run.
Definitely a problem with the release point there, and it just comes back to bite them. They're going to get away from you at times, but you just can't let it happen with the bases loaded. That's a painful RBI for the hitter.
Crawford swings through it for strike one.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's got good numbers swinging at pitches in that location.
The next pitch misses, and that is ball one. In the air to left center. Ward drifts towards it. Makes the catch for the second out.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
And here is Tommy La Stella for the fourth time tonight. Now the 0-1. Up the middle, Fletcher collects, whips it to first on the run. And that'll keep more runs from coming in, inning over. Two runs in the inning. Back here at the ballpark, now it's the power speed combo, Shohei Ohtani. Seawall back to work. Swing and a miss as he was out front. And takes low for ball one.
Trying to keep good speed off the bases.
Next offering is fouled back. And a 1-2. Got him looking for the strikeout. Not sure about that call. Pitcher might have gotten a friendly strike three. Taylor Ward, the next to hit for the Angels. He swings and drives one out to deep left field. That's back there. Feeling for the wall as he makes the catch.
That's just a really nice catch on the run right there. He saved extra bases for sure. If the pitcher's his friend, he'll give him a second to catch his breath before he's ready to deal the next pitch.
Next one misses, 2-0. Bounced up the middle. And the inning is over. Angels go. Here comes Ryan Tepera to the hill. Now here is A.J. Pollock. And a pitch. Ball one, no strikes. And here comes. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
That's one of those swing now before the pitchers even let go of the baseball.
Kicks and deals. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, that slider down and away. It's just kind of a slow death. With two strikes, you're looking to protect. And halfway to the plate, you know you've committed, and you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
Next pitch misses, and that's ball one. And that's outside.
Two balls, one strike.
Bunts it in the air. Tracks it down for the out. And there are two down. So digging in, Dylan Moore. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Now one and one. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to take that right back up the middle approach.
Next pitch is downstairs. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Pitch. Good eye right there.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Ugly cut on the slide. Ready to begin the eighth. Anthony Rendon making his way to the plate. The pitch. And there's a strike. That one misses, 1-1.
It's getting squeezed a little bit here late.
Swings and misses. That is strike two. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
2-0. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Now it's the right fielder, Brett Phillips. 1-for-3. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Matt Vesta.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep him within striking distance.
0-1 now. That one ran inside, almost got him. On the ground, and that's just foul. Left-hand hitter waits. That one to first, and foul ball. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Oh, and he hit him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
No, I like his intent there to be aggressive with the slider and make sure he got it inside, but he just yanked it across his body. A little too much horizontal rotation with the upper body instead of north-south.
Move over to first, trying to keep him close. Next pitch is inside, ball one. That's a strike. One run game, one out, one on. The 1-2. He goes down looking. Gio Urshela to the plate. He's already homered in this game. First pitch, just misses.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on.
Checks over to first, back safely. Phillips off of first with two away. In the air, right side of the infield. Makes a nice running catch. And that is that. Angels get one with a solo homer. And this is now an 8-7. They go with one of their more experienced arms in this spot, Aaron Loop.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Urshela to first in time. And that is a big first out.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Hernandez swings through it for strike one. Next pitch is outside. Looking to get the tying run on base. There's a sinker at the knees for a strike. And a pitch. Swung on, belted. Deep left field. That one on its way. Gone. Teoscar Hernandez hits one out, his second of the year, and they tie it up. It's 8-8. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boog. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dish. That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Now the Mariners catcher, Tom Murphy.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
First offering way inside, almost got him. Good eye right there.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number nine hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
The next offering misses, and that's ball three. Kicks and fires. And there's a foul ball. Back and forth we go. A seesaw battle in the late stages of this one. Out to short. Fletcher handles the chance. Tosses to first. And they got him. Here's the Mariners' leadoff man, Julio Rodriguez. Not your prototypical leadoff guy. Gets on base, yes, but also some power. That one fouled off. And he'll one. Down and in, moved his feet. Next offering down low and in the dirt. Bounce to third. Tosses across to first. Inning over. But some late inning heroics as this home run gets us even again. All even now. All set for the start of the inning. And now batting Mike Trout. Festa back to work. In the air, right field. Hauls it in, and there's one away. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Ward can't hold up, and that's a strike. Out towards left center. Can't get there, base hit. It's a double. Third hit of the night for him.
Three hits in this one, all of them for extra bases. What a game. Got a good pitch to drive, stayed short with his bat path to the ball and caught it out front, and he stayed long in his follow through. That's how you split the gap, and that's pretty much a double every time. And a huge opportunity now to grab the lead at this point in the game.
Diego Castillo gets the call from the pen. Line drive, base hit. One run is in, and that rolls into the corner. The run comes in from second. It's 10-8. It's a two-run double, and they have the lead. One out, runner at second. Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate. First offering misses the mark. Castillo, in his fifth season, 29 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. The 2-0 is in for a strike. Walsh leads off second with one gone in the inning. The punch out there, two gone.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
Next offering is in for a strike. And a big swing and a miss. One and two now. Stays alive. Here's a 1-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. And it's now a 10-8 ball game. So the Angels turn to their bullpen for a new pitcher, Jimmy Hergett.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Makes the catch for the out. And now for Seattle, Tommy La Stella. Mariners going with a pinch hitter, Jarred Kelnick. One out, the base is empty for him. And that's in there for strike one.
No ball, one strike.
And there's a ball. Next offering in the dirt, and it's 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Righty delivers to the right side. The flip to the pitcher covering, down to the last out for the Mariners. A.J. Pollock up next for the Mariners. This to third. Throws it away. And now here is Sam Haggerty. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Bounced out to short. Fletcher gloves it, and that is the ball game.
Well, his first save of the season is in the books, and that was a nice job of him coming in the game and closing it out. He's off and running now.
And this one ends the final 10-8. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long from T-Mobile Park in Seattle.